I believe with all that said, we'll go ahead and get started with our opening remarks. And we'll begin with Mr. Belle.
Well, thank y'all. Thank y'all for coming out today for this and for the debate. Growing up in Gainesville, Georgia, and going to high school at North Hall High School, we also had a place where we had for theatrical and also musical performances in our high school, and we called it the cafeteria. So this is amazing. So I go to North Point Community Church, and there was recently, this past Sunday, they were talking about the word anthem. And that's a word that we don't think of a lot. We also hear it with the national anthem quite a bit, but the meaning of the word anthem. And so as thinking of that word anthem, it means it's a poem or it's a song that basically inspires devotion for a certain group of people. When we talk about the national anthem, we're talking about land of the free, home of the brave. And I was thinking if our campaign had an anthem, it would be to defeat voter fraud and champion Georgia jobs. And so as we've gone across the state of Georgia, it's been amazing just meeting the people of the towns and the communities of the state of Georgia. I'm a sixth generation Georgian. I am a pro-life, free market, Christian conservative. I'm a follower of Christ. I am a 20-year husband to an amazing wife, Candace. I've got two kids. I'm the father of a ballerina who's 13. And I'm a father of a Boy Scout who is now 15 and wanting to drive. So that's amazing. I grew up in Gainesville, Georgia. It is the poultry capital of the world. It says so in our water tower, so it has been confirmed. Most recently, I have been the mayor of Alpharetta in the best job I've ever had in my life. Not the highest paying, but the best job to make Alpharetta the technology city of the South. And it's been my pleasure to run for the Secretary of State in what I consider the most irresistible state in these United States. And with your help, we would love to defeat voter fraud and champion Georgia jobs. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. I want to thank all of you for being here tonight. And there's a lot of other things you could be doing tonight, but you're here to listen to the four of us who aspire to become the next Secretary of State of the state of Georgia. I want to thank the 6th District Republican Party for putting this event on and hosting us here. And I want to thank Kyle Wingfield for coming and asking what I'm sure will be wonderful questions. And I look forward to sharing with you some of my vision for the Office of Secretary of State. You know, I've been active in the Republican Party now for 21 years. Started as a precinct captain, worked my way up, and from 2002 to 2005 was chairman of the Gwinnett County Republican Party. And that was a time when we were flipping the state. It was a Democratic stronghold. And during those years, we flipped to a Republican state, and I was glad to play a small part of that. And, you know, here we are 16 years later, and it kind of feels like the Republican leadership around this state is under assault. It's under threat. Democrats are energized. As I've traveled the state, I've seen that Democrats are meeting in places where President Trump got 75-80%. Now, they may have no shot, but they're still meeting, and they're energized, and they're going to come after us hard this year. To try to, what they call, flip this state back. And I think we've got to work hard to make sure that doesn't happen. And I think how we do that is we re-articulate the conservative principles that we all share, and we carry a positive conservative vision to the people of Georgia of what conservative leadership can mean. As for Office of Secretary of State, two big things that I'm running on, obviously, are election integrity, making sure that we have that we work hard and have the best election system in America, and professional licensing. We have seen an economy that used to have 5% of the workforce that where people were required to have a professional license to almost a third, and that is over-regulation that we need to fight against and work on. And I look forward to sharing more questions with you as the evening goes on. Thank you.
Josh McKoon, your turn.
Good evening. My name is Josh McKoon. I'm running to be your next Secretary of State. My family has really been able to live what we think of as the American dream. My great-grandfather was a mill worker at the Eagle and Phoenix Textile Mill in Columbus, Georgia, in downtown Columbus along the banks of the Chattahoochee River. My grandfather dropped out of school in the eighth grade to help take care of our family during the Depression. He served in World War II in the Pacific. He came home, he married my grandmother, who worked at commercial printers. They had a series of small businesses together, starting with a grocery store at Fifth Avenue and 8th Street in downtown Columbus. The last business they had was a laundromat that owned and operated. I remember refilling the Coca-Cola machine with my granddad. My dad was the first member of our family to go to college. Dad went on to law school, and he's practiced law for the last 40 years. And I followed in my dad's footsteps. I went to Furman University for my undergrad. Went to the University of Alabama for law school. They tell you to go ahead and get the bad news out of the way early in these things. I'm going to tell you that. And I was able to get elected to the state senate and serve the great people of the 29th district for 8 years. And I feel like for the average person, it's getting harder to achieve their American dream because of a government that's gotten too big and gotten in their way. And I think the purpose of those of us that seek elected office as Republicans is to get government out of the way. So I decided to run for Secretary of State. I had two big life changes. In the summer of 2015, my mother was diagnosed with stage 4 pancreatic cancer. She passed away 11 weeks to the day of her diagnosis. In August of 2016, I made the best decision of my life in marrying Jacqueline Byrd. And those two decisions gave me a lot of pause about what I was doing with my life and the time I was spending. I was actually planning on taking a break from elected politics. And then some friends said, hey, you need to get in this race. We need an election lawyer with election law experience. We need somebody with a backbone to stand up to the left. So I'm running to be your Secretary of State to make Georgia the fastest state in the nation to get a job and the toughest state in the nation to cast an illegal vote. Thank you very much.
Good evening. My name is Brad Raffensperger. I'm running for Secretary of State to make sure that only Americans vote in our elections, and to make sure that Georgia is a great place to find a job and a great place to build a business. In both the City Council and also in the State House, I've always worked to protect taxpayers, homeowners, over-regulated businesses, life, and the Second Amendment. On a personal note, I met Tricia, my wife, for 41 years in high school. We got married halfway through engineering school, and we moved here in 1982 and lived in Gwinnett County for a long period of time. This is where we chose to raise our family. This is where we chose to build our businesses. And I'm committed to Georgia. I have a business, and right now we have two manufacturing plants. We have one in Columbus, Georgia. We have another one in Forsyth County. And from those two manufacturing facilities, we've worked on construction projects all over the country, in over 35 states and all over Georgia. And I then have now firsthand experience how some states make it easy to do business and other states make it hard. And as your next Secretary of State, I'm going to make it easy to do business in the state of Georgia. I am a licensed structural engineer, licensed general contractor. And I understand the importance why you want to streamline business regulations and licensing. That's very important. Obviously, elections is the lightning rod for this office. My commitment to you is to make sure that only American citizens vote in our elections. I believe that there's two things you never devalue. That's your currency and your citizenship. This is America, the best country in the whole wide world. When you become American, I hope you vote. So that's why I'm running for Secretary of State, to make sure that only Americans vote in our elections, to make sure that Georgia is a great place to build a business, and also a great place to find a job. Thank you very much.
It's now time for our closing remarks from each candidate. Again, you have 1 minute, and we'll begin with Mr. McKoon.
Thank you for the opportunity to be here this evening. There are three questions you need to answer in deciding who your nominee is going to be. Can they do the job? In my private practice as a lawyer, I've dealt with corporations and elections division. I've handled election contest cases. I've handled ballot access cases. As a member of the state senate, I've dealt with regulated industries and licensed professions. I'm ready to do this job on day one. The second question is, can your candidate defeat John Barrow in the November general election? The Democrats are coming for this office. They're going to spend a lot of money to get there. I've put together a statewide campaign. I'm supported by 21 members of the state senate, including my friend Senator Lindsey Tippins, Cobb County Sheriff Neil Warren, Insurance Commissioner Ralph Hudgens. I've been endorsed by the Georgia Republican Assembly. We're ready to go. We're ready to go in the November election and defeat John Barrow. The third question you need to answer, can you trust the person to do what they tell you they're going to do? ask someone who followed me through the fight on ethics reform if I do what I tell you I'm going to do. Josh McKoon for Secretary of State.
I'm glad the issue of leadership came up. In 1988, I formed a corporation with a partner, and I bought out his interest when he had failing health. I built that company up to 175 people, so I've set the leadership, I've set the vision for that company. And I can do the same for the Secretary of State's office. One of my employees once said, Brad, you've got so many ideas, I can't keep up with you. So that'll be the challenge that I might have as Secretary of State. As a registered professional engineer, I understand licensing, and I understand how important it is. As an elected public servant, I have never voted for a tax increase, never. I'm the only one on this stage here that is 100% rating from the Faith and Freedom Coalition of Georgia. I'll protect the Second Amendment, I'll protect personhood. It just comes to me naturally, that's what I believe in. I will fight to make sure that only Americans vote in our elections, and I'll make sure that Georgia's a great place to find a job and a great place to build a business. And I'm Brad Raffensperger, and I'm asking for your vote on the May 22nd primary. Thank you.
I just want to point out what I'm not running for, or why I'm not running. I'm not running to be, even though I am an attorney, I'm not running to be an election attorney with the Secretary of State's office. I'm not running to be an administrator to make the Secretary of State's office just a little bit more efficient or just a little bit more secure in our voting. I'm not even running for the Secretary of State's office to make a better Secretary of State's office for Georgia. That'll happen. I'm running to make a better Georgia through the Secretary of State's office. We have three legislators. We've got one mayor. We've got one executive who knows how to accomplish things that are beyond the authority and the resources of that office. When it comes to John Barrow, I've raised twice as much as anybody on this stage. John Barrow has raised just a little bit more than me. But if we're going to be able to beat John Barrow, it's not about rattling sabers behind a bank of microphones. It's going to be about being able to lead a vision and cast a vision that is bigger than an office, because it's not just about defeating voter fraud. It's also about championing Georgia jobs, and I hope you'll sing that anthem with me. Thank you.
Again, it's an honor to be here tonight. Thank you, Kyle, for asking these great questions, and thank all of you for being here. My name again is Buzz Brockway, and I'm asking for your vote for Secretary of State. You know, there's a lot of folks who look at the Office of Secretary of State as a stepping stone to something else, or something to do to buy the time until another election comes up and they can run for other offices. That's not why I'm running for this office. I want to do the job of Secretary of State. I'm nerdy enough to care about how long election lines are on election day. I'm nerdy enough to care about how long it takes for somebody to start a business in this country or in this state or get a professional license. And you know, one of my favorite movies is the movie Braveheart. And there's a great line in there, I think, that speaks to our political time. William Wallace looks at the Scottish nobles and says, "You think that the people exist to provide you with a position, but I think your position exists to provide people with freedom." And more than anything else, why the Office of Secretary of State exists is to protect your freedom, whether it's through elections or whether it's through professional licensing. And I'll wake up every day and I'll remember that and I'll work to protect your freedom. Thank you.
Please join me in thanking all of our candidates here for the day. I've done a lot of these. I don't think I've ever done one before tonight where I didn't have to award a rebuttal time.